can stay for a while. My boyfriend's gone. Hey guys, Sunny Boy here, and I'm bringing you another commentary. And I'm juiced up today because I'm bringing you a great Halo 3 commentary. Or, I don't know, you decide if it's great or not, but it's a great gameplay, I think, at least in my book. Well, you're watching some Halo 3, and it's high day, or big day, big times, whatever you want to call it. I love this game. This is back when I was in its prime, back with Call of Duty 4, and these were like the two top games at the time. What you're watching is an MLG gameplay from the Halo 3 MLG playlist, and it's me, my friend House of the Clown, and my other friend Knox Matthews, who are playing against some actual Halo 3 pros. Suddoth 2 and his team at the time, we ran into them online just magically, just through the mystical ways of matchmaking system. But we were just wanting to play against them. We're just like, we got matched up, and it was just like, holy crap, it's Halo 3 pros. Because we were pretty high ranks on the MLG playlist. So we were just like, let's do this, let's go. I want to play against them. Because these guys actually go to the LAN tournaments, those MLG tournaments. These guys play for money and stuff all the time. They're pretty damn good at it, so we're gonna see how best we can do. And we ended up winning at the end, which was very surprising for me. I mean, I knew we would put up a fight against them. I mean, we were no slacks at the time. We were a good team. We were a good solid three. We played for like half a year with each other, but we're nowhere near as good as these guys. But then I guess we can even surprise the best at times. The big upsetting fact, I mean, you would be like, oh, who's upset playing against some Halo 3 pros? But at the end, we were beating them at the end with like, we were up by like 7 kills and we were at 45, and the highest you can get is 50. The total's 50 kills, so you hit the max. And around then, they started lag switching us, which kind of really, really hit me home, like hard. I was just like kind of like a little upset. I was just like, really? I was like, you guys are pros. I mean, like, just can't you accept the loss over Xbox Live? I was like, who cares if you lose? I was just like, it's just, it doesn't matter. But the fact that they try and cheat it against us and like lag switch, and it just made like the whole experience, I guess, not as fulfilling as it could have been. Like, if they played like straight the whole way through, it would have been fine. I mean, at first we were like kind of having like a shaky start, and I was like, oh, we can kind of hang with them. See, they're not so great. And then they started like doing like kicking our ass, and then it was just like, oh god, I forgot we're playing against Halo 3 pros. But we come back and we surprise them, you know. So we're not that totally bad, but I don't know. You be the judge factor of that. And there's a couple things I want to talk about. I wanted to talk about, like, I guess, nades in Halo, routes, positioning, teamwork, and juking. So I want to talk about nades. Like, you'll see me constantly throw nades at the ground all the time. Like, right there, bounce nades. You want to throw your nades. If you're backing away, jumping around a corner, throwing a nade like that to kill them, or a pre-nade. Like, you'll see me later on the video, I'll call it out. Pre-nades are basically, they were used in Halo a lot, or like all the Halo games, where it's basically you just throw a nade around the corner, or in prediction that you think someone's going to be there. You don't know exactly, and sorry, I'm breathing the mic, I'll move it away a little bit. But basically, the whole idea of a pre-nade is you predict someone's going to be there, so you throw a nade in an attempt to stop them, or damage them a little bit, so when they come around the corner, you have the advantage automatically. And this is, I think, the first time I grab the sniper, and I kind of fail with it a little bit. You'll see right here. I back off, and I get the call bottom in. I shoot my teammate in the chest, actually, trying to almost kill him, and I fail with the no-scope. Shot him right through the legs, and then Clown cleans him up, thankfully. So I don't feel that bad, but juking right here. This is, like, that. What he did is just juked our team. I called him out S1 and then S2, and he juked our whole team out. And just assassinated both of them. And this is the pre-nade I was talking about. Like, I predicted someone was going to be there. Bounced the nade. Got splash damage. And this guy juked me out completely. Suddoth 2. Good play, bro. He did the S1, S2 jump again. Juked me out. I thought he was going to be to the left. He got the better of me. So you saw juking at its best right there. And I'm usually the one juking other people. He put on a show right there. So another thing is routes. You want to take the right routes. I mean, I don't always take the right routes, but sometimes I get a bit eager, and you're on the matchmaking, you get all hyped up, and you're like, and you run around, and you get a kill, and you're all like, woo! And then you start running around more, and you get out of focus. So routes are really important. You gotta pick the smart routes, the routes that will least exposure to the other team, the routes where you can take the least amount of damage. I'm like, here's not a great route to be pushing out, but then I realize I push back. So You just want to play smart, keep your head level, and always communicate. That's another communication. Like right here, pushing top mid, very stupid of me. I try and make it up, and I'm trying to push out, but I was just, stuck top mid. He had me pinned down. I should have went left, but whatever. It's in the heat of the moment. You got to think right then and there, otherwise you're going to get called out. So, like I was saying, communication. We had great communication. Like I said before, we were playing 6 months, probably six, yeah, around 6 months with each other, and we had good communication here. Here's a great play by me, I think, in my book. You may not. You'd be like, well, Sunny Boy, you died. Why? Well, I was like, I was going to get out BR there. I was going to lose the BR fight, and I honestly understood that at that time. So my instant reaction was to two-shot beatdown, which, if you know, was an automatic kill. It's just bam, bam, smacked him down with your gun, and it was an automatic kill. So instead of just dying and losing the BR fight, trying to out-BR him, I decided to go for the easy switch kill, which you just go kill for kill, and basically nothing happened. He died, I died. So each team gets a point, so we still keep that little lead gap. And that's one of those things you gotta decide. You gotta decide, like, should I just try and out BR him? And at the beginning, I kind of was a little shaky, so I just went for the quick, easy, just kill for kill. Swap out your kills. And I dropped down, and I think it's a video just glitched. I dropped down and cleaned him up eventually, but right here, just calling out. Here, I call out the clown. Like, this is what I was saying, communication. I called him out, clown. Didn't get a death there, and turns around, out BRs the kid with some of my help, and the whole shooting. And here, I call out these two guys, and then this is more communication. I call, put shots on these guys, Clown lifts over, and now I put shots on him, but Clown calls out the other kid on the far tunnel. This one right here is one shot, so I put shots on him. And this is also chasing, which I want to cover. You do not want to chase people, whether it's Call of Duty or Halo, don't chase, because you saw what happened to that kid. I mean, I got a bit lucky, but you saw what happens when you can chase. I mean, bad things can happen. I pick up the nice double kill right there and give us a nice five kill lead. Yeah, I can't talk right now. I gotta work on that, but regardless, this is where I start heating up, clean up Giggle Monster. Here I get Suddoth 2 gets called out, so I pick him up, get a nice kill right there. And then my two teammates go down right around here, and I'm a bit worried. Then he avoids me, and I get a five shot, which is pretty good. And here I really liked it. I get a nice four shot in the guy. I ended up dying, but I got two kills for my one death, so I'm happy with that. And in Halo, you don't worry about your KD. KD is a non-factor when you're playing Halo. It's all about that win, all about that W at the end. Because whoever wins gets a smack talk. So I don't know why people worry about KD. If you're playing for KD in Halo, you're stupid. If you're playing for KD in Call of Duty, whatever. Some people desire, like, that's their desire to have a high KD. When you're playing Halo, it's all about that W, it's all about that teamwork. And that's all I cared about in Halo. I mean, I came out with Halo 3 with like a 1.5 KD. So if you're worrying about your KD, then you're worrying about the wrong stat. Because you can score all the points you want in a professional sports game, whatever. If you don't got that ring or that cup at the end of the year, who gives a shit, really? I was like, you could be the best like hockey NFL player, but if you don't have nothing to show for it, you ain't got no ring or no trophy to back it up, then I don't know what to say. Just, you ain't the best then, apparently. Or you're not on a good enough team. Gotta find some better players. But like I was saying, this is the whole lag switch thing. This is me like running around the map, like, just what the hell is going on as you're watching? It's just, yeah, and this is what really pissed me off. It's like they were trying to lag switch us because we were about to win. And all of a sudden you'll see they catch up. Like, we're at 47. And they're at 41, and then, like, after this, they all of a sudden, they, like, catch up, and they're only, like, two kills behind. I was like, whoa, what the hell's going on? And I'm, like, freaking out. I'm like, oh, goodness, they're, like, switching us. I mean, this was a common thing if you played high-ranked Halo 3. Because a bunch of people, like, look, all of a sudden, they got three kills. We got one kill. I had no clue what's going on. I was like, goodness, they're catching up. Like, we're all dying. Look, it's 49, 45. And here, I'm just like, I'm like, oh my god, he's going to out-BR me. I was like, I'm going to lose. I was like, they can actually come back with, like, this whole lag switch thing. And then eventually we go up and clean them up. And yeah, we demolished their team in the end. So, I'm Sunny Boy. Peace!